In this video, we'll see how to run a particular test set. One test set might contain one test case or more than that. So if I want to execute all the test cases which are present into my test set, we'll be working on this run a test set. So let us see practically how do I execute a test set. So let us see now how do we execute a particular test set. Now I'm in the test lab. I've selected this smoke testing test set. And if I want to execute this entire set, I can just simply click on this run test set button here. This is enabled always, but this button on the left hand side only enables when you click on this execution grid. So right now I'll just click on this details. When I click on this run test set, I'll be getting a dialog box. This dialog box says, which way do you want to run this particular test? So using a sprinter, sprinter is nothing but an add-in which can be used for execution and recording purpose, which we'll see in the later videos. Second one is manual runner. Like you execute test case in Excel using manual testing, we use the same thing. But if you see in the bracket, run according to the order in the execution grid. At the back end, if you see, there's an execution grid. So I'll just click on cancel to show you. In the execution grid, whatever is the sequence given, according to that, the HP ALM will execute the test cases here. That's the test instance. So now if I click on this run test set, and if I select the manual test runner, it will follow this sequence. That is, first one, it will go for American Express, second MasterCard, third one as Visa, and fourth one as login. If I select the automatic runner, this will execute using some automation tool like LoadRunner or HP QTP or newly named as UFT, any other tool, automation tool. So this will run according to the order of execution flow. I'll click on cancel and I'll go to execution flow. So whatever the sequence is defined here, first it will go to login and then it will work on the other test cases. So this is the sequence they'll follow. So remember, if you're working on manual runner, this is the sequence they follow. If you're using for automation tool, this is the sequence they'll follow. Now I'll just click on this run test set, select the option as manual runner, and then click on OK. Once I click on OK, I'll be getting a dialog box here which says manual runner test set smoke testing, if you read the heading, and the test name is American Express, that's a test instance. Now if you observe, I have got the run name and the test instance name, tester name, status, and the test set name itself. So this details which are given in the red color, the fields, those are mandatory, whereas the other fields are not mandatory. Even if you leave the other fields, still it will work. Now what can be done here is, now first thing is, I'll just change the name of this run. I'll give as American, or I can say as American Express underscore one, some name I'll give just to distinguish. And then I can just simply click on this begin run. So observe, first this test case will execute. I'll just click on this begin run. And what are the parameters you want? So I'll select the first parameter as username as my name, Pawan. Click on OK. I also had to use password here. I didn't use it. So now if you observe, I'm getting the test steps here, the second page. That is login, select a flight. I'll expand it. So login, select a flight destination, enter departure. So all these steps one by one I need to execute. So if you see here, it says enter URL, enter username, enter password. So now I'll not execute all these steps one by one. I'll just write as same as expected. Same as expected. Actually, you have to open the application and then enter the details, whatever they say. And here what I'll do is, I'll select from this drop down as passed. Now, suppose I go to the second step here, select a flight destination, and suppose any step is not matching here. So I'll write as error message is displayed, preventing user to proceed further. I'm just entering a demo message here, and actually actual message which is given, actual result. Error message is displayed, preventing user to proceed further, and this would be given as pass. That is a fail status. Now, suppose this is a fail status, it is not allowing me to proceed further. I can simply select this option as fail all. That means other test cases are not working properly here. So the other test steps are been failed. So I'll select as failed all. And if you observe, all these steps are been failed here. Okay. And I can simply click on this stop button, that is the end run. So once I click on that place, that window will close, American Express. This is the second one. If you see the heading, this is for MasterCard.
So I'll select here's MasterCard underscore one, and then I'll click on this begin run. I'll select the values here as, I'll enter some actual value again. I'll enter for Rita in the actual value tab itself, Rita. Select the second one as the password as again Rita, and I'll click on OK. Now these are the steps which are visible here. Now if you want, you can execute one by one each step by opening the application like this. I can just minimize it, and I can open this web application. You can enter the URL like this. You can just paste the URL, whatever you want, and then you can enter the username as Rita. So if this is the same thing, and if you click on the sign in button, so one by one each step you have to match, like enter URL, enter username, enter password, you have entered, and here I can just write as same as expected. It's a lengthy, so I'm not executing the entire test case, same as expected. And finally I can say this one as status as pass. So similarly, if I execute all the steps here, and if I click on this place as pass all, that means all the steps would be passed here, and then I can click on this stop, or you can say end run. So we have done with the second one, and now I'll execute the third one. Remember, we are working with the test set. I'm executing the entire test set. One test set can contain more than one test instances. This is the third instance which you're working right now. I'll click on this begin run, and here I can enter the value as Robert, and second one also I'll enter as Robert. Click on OK. So the third instance will work now, right? So this is the instance. Again, I'll select all the options as pass all, and then I'll click on this end run. And the last one, I have this login. So I'll write as login underscore one, and then I'll click on this begin run. Select some username as Robert, and again a password also as Robert. Click on OK. All right. So let's make this entire test case as fail. I've made as failed, and click on this end run. So once the execution is done, I'll be navigated back to this HP ALM. This is the HP ALM. And now how do you see the results? If I go to this test run, I'll be getting the test run for all these options. If you see American Express underscore one, login underscore one, MasterCard and Visa underscore one. But if you go back to this test lab, select the option as execution grid, and then you can click on this refresh button here. And if you observe, the status of this instances have changed. If I select American Express, and if you see the last run result, for detail about every step will be mentioned here, like all have been failed. If I select this MasterCard, it will say as all have been passed. And when you click on any step, you'll be getting details about that particular step. Same way if I click on this login part. These are just the results run last run report. But if you want to see reports in detail, you can just go to this test run. Click on any one, the run ID. I'll click on 33. I'll be getting a dialog box, and these are the same details what we have entered while execution. If you remember the test run name, and then the status has become as failed. If I click on the steps part, I'll be getting all the steps. Details about every step can be mentioned, and they can be remembered here, right? So I'll just click on this close button, and now let us see what is the impact of doing this on the requirements. Right now, if I go to this test lab, smoke testing, and if you observe, this test cases are being attached to one requirement, that's the one test case. The name of the test case is book flight ticket. So I'll take you back to this test plan. In this test plan, if I click on this book flight ticket, and there are two things, one is flights and registration. Okay, so I'll just click on this flights part, flights requirement. And still there are no changes. If you see, my cursor is on the flights requirement. I'm jumped to this flights requirement here, flights tab. Now when I click on this refresh button, and if you see what is the status of this flights requirement, it would be changed. Now if you observe flights, it has said as failed, registration failed, login failed. Now remember, if any one test case of the requirement fails, for example, if I just double click and open this requirement, or I can select this one and select this option as requirement details. Let me explain you this. If I go to test coverage, and here it says filter, the coverage status is given here. So I'll first clear the filter. Yeah. Now if you observe here for book, that is a test coverage, book flight ticket, it is showing as failed. But if you see, book flight ticket has three configurations. For configurations extra, you can see the details about that. So one flight, that is the book flight ticket, has three configurations, and out of that, and here if you see at the bottom, test configuration, American Express failed, Visa is passed and MasterCard is passed. So out of three, even if one fails, the entire test case fails, and if one test case fails, the entire requirement fails. So this is the status which you can see here by reflecting. Now if you click on refresh, whatever is the recent status can be reflected here. So because American Express failed, the test case failed. If test case failed, then this flight's requirement has been failed, right? So I'll come back to this test lab, and this is how we can execute the entire test set. You'll be getting a status here, and those status would be reflected in the requirements, and same in the releases and the cycles part. So I hope you have understood how to work on executing the entire test set, and that's all for this video.